Hi and welcome to this tutorial about the new scan projection wizard introduced in Mavic 6. The scan wizard was created to help speed up workflows where you need to project source images from photogrammetry back onto a model for your texturing process. The end result of the wizard consists of two things. Number one, a set of cameras in the projector palette, fully set up with corresponding images, transformations, correct color spaces, etc. And number two, a non-destructive node graph setup that live projects images that can be masked and even transformed interactively. In a traditional projector workflow, you would manually import different images onto your projector, bring the images into the paint buffer via the import button, then delete parts of the images you don't want to keep and project the result onto the model. Using the wizard's node graph setup, this whole process is non-destructive, and you can grade or change the masking of different projections at any time. Of course, since the projectors themselves are fully set up for you, nothing is stopping you from supplementing the new node workflow with the traditional import and projection method. Or if you're just comfortable with the old workflow, at least the wizard will help you with quickly getting the projectors set up and ready for painting. Before we really dive into the setup process, let's cover the prerequisites of the data we're going to use. I have a camera array here in Maya and a set of images. You can see that the camera names correspond to the image names, which is a requirement for the scan wizard. There is, however, some leniency, as the wizard only compares the beginning of image names against the cameras. So for example, an image file like this would match up against a camera name like this, even though there is extra naming info appended to the camera name. Now before we export our camera array, let's quickly talk about file formats. Depending on which file format you use to export the cameras, Mari will interpret their name differently. If you are using FBX to save the cameras, Mari will use the transform name of the camera, which we see here. If, however, we are using Alembic to save the cameras, Mari will use the shape name of the cameras. If we look at the shape names of the cameras in this scene, you may notice that in this case the shape name is very generic. Camera shape 1, camera shape 2, etc. So if here we would use Alembic to export and bring those cameras into Mari, we would have camera names that do not correspond to the image names. Because of that, I will use FBX to export, and depending on when you watch this video, the newest FBX version will be different, but for Mari 6 we will use FBX 2020. Now after all of this pre-talk, let's head into Mari and get our projection setup going. The wizard can be found in the Projectors palette as part of the exposed buttons, as well as in the right mouse click context menu. The first thing we want to do is import our camera array we just exported. If you already manually loaded the cameras into Mari, you can skip this step and proceed onwards. We only need one frame, so no animation. And let's hit OK. You can see here we loaded all 29 cameras in, and in the projectors list we see our cameras with correct naming. Next, we want to point the wizard to our image location. So usually this would be, for example, cross-polarized images pre-processed for your pipeline's color space. If you know the color space and bitdepth of the images, you can set this here. Otherwise, leave it on automatic and standard OCIO color space rules will be applied. The color space and bitdepth are considered when setting up your projectors correctly, as well as loading in images into Mari for the live projection setup in the node graph. In this next dialog, you can set which actions the wizard should perform. As we discussed in the beginning of the video, the wizard can set up your projectors for you for the traditional projection workflow, as well as set up a projection node graph. I'm going to leave both on here, even though I'm more interested in the node graph workflow, but the setup of the projectors doesn't hurt me. In this dialog page, we can choose if we want to have our projection graph created as a loose unconnected graph group, or if the node graph group should be added to a pre-existing channel in a Layerstack compatible way. For illustration purposes, I'm just going to add it to a channel here. The name field is going to be used for node and image manager naming, so it's totally up to you if you want to change that. Finally, we will choose our resolution and bitdepth for the masks that are associated to each projection. But don't worry, of course, this being Mari, you can easily change the resolution of those later on. The default color determines if you want to work with projection masks subtractive, so hiding projection parts you don't want, or additive, where all projections are hidden by default and you only reveal what you really need. The Use Previously Broadcasted Mask checkbox is useful if you want to set up multiple different projection setups, for example to project multiple channels. If the checkbox is ticked on and a previous setup is detected, the painted masks from that setup are being reused via teleport nodes in a workflow comparable to Mari's shared layer system. Mari will now load in all the images from the previously specified folder. Only images that it can associate to projectors will be loaded, and if you import cameras via the wizard, only those cameras will be processed. Once that is done, we can choose which images we want to include in the node graph projection setup. Oftentimes, you will only need a handful of images to have full coverage. So if you already have experience in this kind of work, you can pre-select items here or simply select all and delete later. The Remove Unused Images checkbox will remove any non-selected images that are no longer in use when you finish the setup to keep your project light. Now let's wrap up the wizard setup. And once we're done, we can see in our after action report that there was one projector where no associated image was found. So this report can be helpful to identify issues. Now that the setup is complete, let's check out what we got. Each of my projectors has the correct file associated to it, the correct transform set, and the color space configured. Here in my node graph, I have my 3D scan graph group that is set up in a Layerstack compatible way. On the scan group, we can turn off individual projections, configure the facing ratio for the projections, and transform the entire camera array. The array transform can be useful if you had, for example, a person that did not stand perfectly straight and your retopologized model no longer 100% aligns with the original photogrammetry highres model. You can enter values manually in here or use the transform selected object tool, hotkey shift and T, to transform the array directly in your viewport. To uniformly scale here, hold Ctrl and Shift and drag on one of the scale handles. Now all of those exposed options are nice and all, but we really want more control. So let's enter the graph group. We can do so by clicking on the graph icon in the layer stack, or inside the node graph pressing the I hotkey or Ctrl and double click with the graph group selected. Inside the graph group, we will find a standardized setup with each block being a separate projection. On the far left here, we have our camera array transform, which is connected to the position input of each projection node. Let's inspect the standard node setup for each projection. At the top here, we have a line of mix nodes, each one blending a projection into the stream of previous projections. To disable a projection layer, you can select the mix node and press D to disable it. At the top of each projection group, we have a simple switch node. This is a checkbox that also disables the projection, and the checkbox is exposed to the group node properties. We then have an HSV and grade node to color correct individual projections. Each one of those has the option to attach a mask to the mask port of the node in order to limit where the color correction is applied. Next, we have a camera projection node. You can see the projection node is associated to our projector's camera in the projector's palette. The transforms of the camera are transferred onto the node, meaning that even if I delete a projector from my projector's list, the previously associated projection node will continue to work correctly. The scale of the projector is determined by the aspect ratio of the associated image. Our fades are exposed to the outside of the graph group, where they are all linked together into one control. If you want to control them individually, simply click here to unexpose an attribute. As mentioned, each camera projection by default is hooked up to the camera array transform node in order to control the transforms for all cameras in the array simultaneously. If you want to add a transformation for just a specific camera, insert a manifold 3D node into the stream of the node you want to add more control to. So this way we can modify just a single projection transform while still having synced up transforms available as well. Last but not least, we have our projection mask, which is a paintable node that allows me to limit the influence of a specific projection. The projection mask is automatically broadcasted via teleport nodes and can be reused in a second setup automatically for a synced up multi-channel projection. If you want to reorder projection groups, you can easily do so by selecting one or multiple nodes from groups and pressing the arrow buttons in the Projectors palette. Your order is automatically recorded, so the next time you set up your projections, for example, for a matching displacement channel, the same order is rebuilt. Now, in a usual digi-double workflow, I would clean up and mask together my projections, potentially disabling projections I don't need, grade them, etc. Once I'm in a good spot, I would then likely at one point bake the result into a paint node, and maybe fine-tune with the traditional projector workflow.